Sanbonani Africa, Jiri Say, and welcome to yet another episode of NBA Africa Game Time. My name is Sho Madjozi, and as usual, I'm bringing you lifestyle, I'm bringing you culture, and I'm bringing you the best game on earth. Of course, that's basketball. Today, I've got a jam-packed show for you. I'll be giving you updates on the NBA Finals, and I know you can't wait for that, but also a conversation with a special guest, rugby superstar Tendai, the beast, Mtawarira. Let's get it going. The Golden State Warriors have kept their hope of winning a third straight championship alive in Game 5, beating the Toronto Raptors 106-105 on the road. It wasn't all great for the Dubs as they lost superstar Kevin Durant to injury though, and our thoughts definitely going out to KD right now. Catch Game 6 of the NBA Finals on Friday morning at 3 a.m. Central African Time right here on NBA Africa's YouTube channel. And remember, after the game is done, it'll still be available right here on our channel for you to watch at any time. In trends, four-time NBA champion Tony Parker announced his retirement at age 37. He joins legends Dwayne Wade and Dirk Nowitzki in making 2019 the last season they ever graced the NBA hardwood. These guys will definitely be missed. Tony's career comes to an end, but the game keeps going. With that, let's check out some of the best moments from Game 5 of the NBA Finals. This week on Crossover, we check out the NBA Academy Africa as they visit a center for abandoned and orphaned kids in Senegal. The players really seem to have a good time with the kids, and that's the kind of paying it forward we love to see. Well done, boys. So earlier this week, I sat down with Tendai the Beast Mtawarira, a man who has excelled at every level in rugby. He's a Springbok and he recently became the most capped Super Rugby player in all of South African history. And we talked about hoops, we talked about his new book, and of course I put him through a tough game of quick fire. Take a look. Tendai the Beast Mtawarira, how are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Thank you so much for joining me.
No, thanks for having me on.
Let's get straight to business. Which is the better sport?
Rugby, definitely. But basketball is my second love, so yeah, I'd say those are the two best sports in the world. Yeah.
Unbelievable. He is a huge basketball fan. It's just that obviously his job and whatever. What makes you so attracted to basketball?
No, I think one thing about basketball, you know, it involves a lot of skill, and I think that's what I really impresses me. I think, you know, the dunks, you know, on the court, and you know, just the amazing size of those human beings, you know, that can do these amazing things, e.g. LeBron James. You know, I'm just in awe of those guys, and I think I'm just such a fan.
It's nice to hear another sports player sort of big up other sports stars. That's nice.
Yeah, that's good. We you know, we always look out for inspiration in outside our own, you know, game. So I think basketball is always a go-to for us.
Nice one. You came to the NBA Africa game in 2018.
Yes.
Were you looking for inspiration there, and how did that go?
No, it was amazing. It was incredible, you know, just to get to see guys you usually watch on TV, you know, being like right next to you, you know, guys like Joel Embiid, JaVale McGee, and Bismack Biyombo, even Carmelo Anthony, even though he didn't play. But it was, yeah, it was just incredible. And also having a conversation with the NBA commissioner, Adam Silver, was also, you know, quite inspiring. And these guys are really humble as well. And that's probably one of the things that really moved me, you know,
right.
Just to see how humble and down to earth they are. And now they think about Africa, you know, even though there were some of them were born here and then they're applying their trading in the States, but they've never forgotten, you know, where they come from. So it was amazing.
That wasn't the only NBA experience you've had. Tell us about the Lakers game that you went to recently.
No, that was something else. Next level, yeah. yeah, I got to get a VIP tour of the Staples Center. I was there just in November when LeBron obviously just joined the Lakers. So I got to, you know, go on the sitting on the court and watch them play the Jazz, and I even shook hands with some of the big stars like Lance Stevenson, you know, all these guys that are really great, and they've been amazing for the Lakers. But yeah, just incredible experience overall, and one I'll never forget.
Is there an NBA player that you watch and you're like, this could play rugby?
I would say definitely LeBron.
Could do anything. LeBron could do anything.
Exactly. LeBron can be anything.
For sure.
I think because of his physical attributes, you know, he's strong, he's aggressive, and it's the same as us rugby players. And I think he'll be probably in the back row, in the forwards, if you get to play rugby, and then as well jump in the lineouts because he's good at the ball in hand.
You seem to be going into very different field than what you're known for right now. You're writing an autobiography. Tell me about that.
Oh, yes, yeah. Quite an amazing thing that I embarked on last year, beginning of last year, because I thought to myself, you know, I've got quite a unique story, you know, and I came from Zimbabwe, and, you know, and obviously now I'm playing for South Africa. I'm a Springbok. I've been the longest serving for this current squad. And I thought to myself, I really had to get my story out there and inspire, you know, the next generation. So I started working with a guy called Andy Capistano. He's actually an Englishman that lives in South Africa and has been involved in rugby commentary for a long time. So I decided, you know, to get my story out there. So it's been a year-long project, and eventually now, you know, we're rolling it out, and we've started with the pre-orders. And I think if you want to know more about me, just get a book, and you won't regret it.
I love it. What's the title of the book?
Yes, the title is pretty simple. It's just Beast, and my name underneath, Tendai, Mtawarira, my story. So simple as that, just Beast, yeah.
All right, a book with a very simple title. Now onto something a lot less simple. It's time for Quickfire, this time with the Beast. This is going to be extremely challenging. Let me just put it out there. You have two players in your hand.
Yes.
You have Dwayne Wade.
Yes.
And you have Doncic.
Yes.
Yay! I'm going to ask you 10 questions. Okay. The answer is either D. Wade, in which case you're going to put up his symbol there.
Okay.
Or it's going to be Luka Doncic, and you're going to put that up. So you have pretty much 50-50% chance. I'm not going to tell you how some of our other guests have done.
Okay.
This is your opportunity to do your best, put yourself out there.
I'm sure I'm going to do well. I'm sure I'm going to be the best you ever got.
Activate beast mode. The first question, which player participated in college basketball prior to starting their NBA career? That is the correct answer, D. Wade.
Thank you.
Nice. Which player was drafted higher between the two? No!
Damn.
No.
Okay. I got that.
He was like the best rookie. Okay. The correct answer is Luka Doncic. Okay. Who averaged a higher field goal percentage last season? No! That is the incorrect answer.
Okay, I really don't know my stats. So.
You got this. Okay, this one, I don't know. It's easy if you've seen them standing next to each other. Which player is taller between the two? Please don't do this to me. No, what are you doing to me right now?
I've never seen them next to each other.
Who averaged more points per game in their rookie season?
Definitely.
That is 100% correct. Which player made the playoffs in his first season? D-Wade is the correct answer.
Yes.
Which player has previously worn a jersey with the number 9 on it?
The number 9 on it.
Absolutely correct. Whew, thank you for getting that. I'm like, he's a rookie. What has he previously won?
Yeah, exactly. I thought maybe
in college. Oh, he didn't even do college.
He didn't do college, but he played over somewhere in Europe.
But the answer is Wade. Thank you. Hey, you were giving me stress there. Which player had more triple doubles this season? Thank you, sir. Whew, now that's beast mode. Which player wears Nike shoes on the court? That is the correct answer. Which player was selected to be an NBA All-Star this season? That is the correct answer. Thank you. Not bad at all. Well done.
Thank you.
Here on NBA Africa Game Time, we like to learn a new word every week. So is there a Shona word that relates to basketball that you can teach all of us today?
Yes, yeah. I think there's this word that we always talk about all the time when there's rugby or basketball. Hopefully you can learn it. It's quite hard. It's a long one.
Okay.
Kubambisa.
Kubambisa.
Not bad.
Hey,
so
listen,
it basically means that you're basically bouncing the other guy. You know, like how LeBron just runs on the court and he's, bounces guys off him and he goes and he scores.
Like if you actually hit the ball out of someone's hand or if you intercept the ball,
you have to physically dominate the other guy. So that's, you have to put him on the floor, put him on their backside.
That is obviously coming from a rugby player. Kubambisa.
Yes, that's great.
Thank you. I hope you guys have also learned that one. Again, thank you, Tendai, the beast, Mtawarira.
Peace out.
Wow, the beast. What an amazing guy. I'm so glad I got to sit down with him. I'm wishing him luck on the field, but of course as well with his upcoming book. Now, let's check in with 7-time NBA champion Robert Horry as he weighs in on some of the most promising prospects ahead of next week's NBA draft.
Hey, NBA Africa Game Time.
Horry for three!
Here are my thoughts on three top NBA draft prospects. This is going to be a crazy NBA draft. You got Zion, you got Ja, you got Barrett. These guys, think about it. You haven't had this many guys in the top three that you know them by one name. Zion, you know who that is. Barrett, you know who that is. Ja. These guys have incredible talent. You get a guy who steps on the scene with incredible dunks in Zion. You get a guy like Barrett who can do everything. He's Mr. Basketball on the court, Mr. Intangible. He can make guys around him better. And you got Ja, who's the same way, who can shoot it, but also knows when he can make his teammates better. Like, when you got three guys like that, it depends on who gets the first pick in the draft. You can't go wrong with the top three picks. They're all great players. They're going to be a great addition to the NBA, and hopefully they can turn into superstars.
It's so great to hear from experts like Robert Horry, and it's clear that those guys are going to be the next great players in the NBA. Check out the NBA draft next week, where you get to see those three and some potential African stars. Unfortunately, that's it for this week. Don't forget to check us out on all of our NBA Africa social media pages. So that's Facebook, that's Twitter, and of course right here on YouTube. You definitely want to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of the action. Thank you so much to the Beast for sitting down and talking to me. That was an amazing conversation, and I wish him the best on all his future endeavors. And of course, thank you, the fans, who keep watching NBA Africa Game Time. Until next time, peace.